Wow, it's that time, ladies. It's Monday morning at 6 a.m., and I'm Dr. Beverly with coffee, wisdom, and prayer. So glad to have you this morning. It's so exciting to meet. I have great wisdom to share with you this morning, and I'm so hoping that you'll have testimonies to share with me. Now, we're going to seal this wonderful morning with prayer before we depart today. So go ahead and take this time to gather your cup of coffee or your favorite tea and get into the spot that you love the most, that's most comfortable, or dance around like me. I'm so glad you're here. Hey, listen, this is our year. This is a year to do great things, and I want to take a minute to speak positive affirmations into your life, into your day. So I decree and declare happiness, peace, joy, prosperity, increase. I decree and declare your dreams will come true, promotions, visions, businesses started. Everything that you need for this day is already done. So get ready. Get ready for wisdom. Now that you have your coffee and prayer.
Good morning, ladies, and welcome again. It's Monday morning at 6 a.m., so welcome to Coffee, Wisdom, and Prayer. It's great to join you on a couch today with your favorite tea or coffee and creamer. It's me. It's Dr. Beverly, and I look forward to our Monday morning conversation that'll take us through the week. Just a boost of wisdom and a burst of empowerment to take us through the week. And it is always good to have this time with you. Now, no, this is a time where I am hoping that the hustle and the bustle has yet to start in your household, where you can have a few minutes with Dr. Beverly to just get us going for this week. So I'm hoping that it's still quiet where you are. And if you can't sit still and cross your leg and enjoy that cup of coffee, it's okay. Just go ahead and put me on speaker and I will just chat while you do whatever it is that you need to do these next 20 to 22 minutes. If you ever have any topics that you would like me to talk about, anything that's on your heart, please go ahead and email that to me at info@drbeverlylswanson.com. I've always said every single broadcast, because I mean it. There is nothing too small, nothing too big, and certainly nothing too intimate that we can't talk about. If it's important to you or it's on your heart, I assure you, it's on the heart of other women as well. So don't hesitate to do that, and we will address it. So good morning. It's a fine Monday morning here in Sacramento, California. What I'm going to be talking about today was on my heart, and it is simply give Superwoman a day of rest. It is so important that we do that. Now, I know we just came through Mother's Day, but oh my, ladies, we cannot wait once a year to have a day. Time for us never stops. We are mothers, wives, sisters, best friends, teachers, employers, business workers, employees. We are so many things to so many people that we rarely take time to just be. And it is important to do that. We are not judged by how much we do. We think we are, but we really are not. That is pressure that we tend to put upon ourselves because we have a heart for so many. And that's how we're wired. And that's okay. But is it not okay not to take time set aside to rejuvenate and to refresh and to remind ourselves, not dependent upon anyone else, to remind ourselves how important we are, how valuable we are? We have to do that. And if we don't do that, we can never be at our best. It is absolutely impossible. We must at least take a day that we can refresh, rejuvenate, and spend time with ourselves, doing those things that make us happy, whatever they are, independent of anyone else. We must do that. We wear far too many hats not to do that. And I don't want anyone to feel that they have to be guilty for scrounging up some time for themselves. Now, I'm not talking 1 or 2 hours a week. I'm talking about a full day. Listen, God created the earth in 6 days, and even He took a day to rest. Now, I'm just saying, if God Almighty, the Sovereign One, had to do that, how much more important is it for us? Is that not the greatest example that there could ever be? To take a day to rest. We are superwomen indeed. It truly amazes me, the talents and the gifts that we have. It amazes me that we're able to go as far as we do and do as much as we do for so very many. But it equally amazes me that we don't realize that there comes a time, at least one day out of the 7 days, that we do not take for ourselves. It is my sincere hope that this broadcast encourages us, each and every one of us. And you know, I'm always talking to myself as well when we have our couch and coffee talk. Take that time to just be. Now, I know there is always someone that says, Dr. Beverly, I'm a Proverbs 31 woman. Yeah, okay. Well, praise the Lord for that. We all strive to be a Proverbs 31 woman. But let me point this out to you. A Proverbs 31 woman is so busy. Do you not think that she deserves one day to rest? And here's what it said about a Proverbs 31 woman in the Bible. So the heart of her husband is safely trust in her. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and works willingly with her hands. She's like the merchant ships. She brings food from afar. She rises also while it is yet night and gives meat to her household, basically prepares meals. She considers a field and buys it. She girds her loins with strength. She perceives that her merchandise is good. Her candle doesn't go out by night. She lays her hands to the spindle. She stretches out her hands to the poor. She's not afraid that it's snow for a household because she provides clothes for everyone. She makes herself coverings of tapestry. Her husband is known in the gates and amongst elders because of her. She makes fine linen and sells it. Strength and honor are her clothing. She opens her mouth with wisdom and kindness. She looks well to the ways of her household. Her children arise and call her blessed. Many daughters have done right virtuously, but she excels them all. And my goodness, do you not think that the Proverbs 31 woman deserves one day off where she can love on herself? One day off where she can encourage herself, one day off where she can just think? At least one day? Superwoman, take one day a week. You choose the day based on your own schedule in your own household and rest. Just rest. You deserve that. We all deserve that. Also in the Bible, in the book of Ecclesiastes, in chapter 2, there's verse 24, it says, there is nothing better for a man than that he should eat and drink and that he should make his soul enjoy good in his labor. And we all know that when the Bible says man, he's talking about men and women, except for that Proverbs 31 woman. The Lord says, in all the good that we do, in all the work that we do, it is a good thing to take time in it and relax and enjoy the good that we've done and rest. Can you do that? Can we all do that? As a matter of fact, can we encourage each other to do that? Can we take the time and encourage all our sisters and friends, our daughters? Can we encourage each other in passing? Hey, make sure you take a day of rest. You're beautiful. You're amazing. Your accomplishments are off the charts. You never stop going. You're so encouraging and inspiring. Thank you for being such a prayer warrior. You're the best mother. You're an amazing daughter. But make sure you take a day to rest. Is it not time that we start encouraging each other as women? Is it not time that we start reminding each other how powerful we are, how unique we are, how beautiful we are, how full of wisdom we are, and how important it is that we take one day and rest so that we can continue to be at our best, so that we can continue to be there for many years. And I mean years in good health, so that we can take care of ourselves. Ladies, the world needs us. Men need us. We need to be here for a long time. But we also need each other. I tell you, we are so beautiful. Each and every one of us. We are the apple of God's eye, his very heart. And it is about time we start believing that ourselves. So, I'm not going to labor before you long, because unfortunately, I have been called for jury duty this morning. But I did want to take the time to just talk to us all. And that this time, the day that after Mother's Day, that we do not let Mother's Day be once a year, but we take the time as women, the super women that we are, to take one day each week just for us. Let this be the day that it starts for the rest of our lives so that we can enjoy life, be healthy, that we will always be ready to give of ourselves because we've taken time for ourselves, that we refresh and we rejuvenate and we value ourselves and we love on ourselves. And I assure you, if we do that, we will be appreciated even more because we have taken time to rest so that we can be about our best. I love you all so much, and I hope that this message penetrates your heart. Father, in the name of Jesus, we praise and thank you for this wonderful morning. It is always a blessing that we can come together. We thank you for those prophetic affirmations before the broadcast. We receive it for ourselves, Father, and we receive it for each other. We thank you for your promises that are yes, and so be it. We thank you for your covenant. We thank you, Father God, for blessing us on a daily basis, watching over us, keeping us safe and sound. And we so thank you for the love that you have for us. Father, we're going to bless you by valuing what it is that you've placed in us so much that we're going to take a time every single week, at least one day, to refresh and rejuvenate so that we can be at our best for you and all of those that you've placed in our circle of influence and the very heart of our care. We love you, Lord, for all that it is that you do. We love you and adore you. In Jesus' name, amen. So here we are, ladies. We're ending the broadcast early today so that we can get going with our day. Thank you so much for tuning in this Monday morning. Remember, the broadcast is always available immediately so that you can listen to it over and over again on Spreaker.com under Dr. Beverly L. Swanson or Coffee, Wisdom, and Prayer. And it is also available to watch on YouTube. Just look up or listen to on YouTube. Just look in my name, Dr. Beverly L. Swanson, and you will see my picture. Click it, and all the broadcasts, the podcasts will be there for you to listen to. So appreciative for all of you when you join me in the morning. So thankful that you listen to the broadcast. Don't forget to like it, and I love listening to your comments if you have time to put it in. Thank you so much for sharing it with other women. Let us continue to be a blessing to each other. Now have an amazing day. And as always, this song just uplifts me and gets me going. Trust His Heart by Babbie Mason. Because you know what? It is good.
I'm not worried about tomorrow, for the Lord will work it out somehow. I'm not laden down with sorrow, something good is gonna happen now. Life is the great adventure, rise up, we're called to answer. For life and take it by storm. Time for throwing caution to the wind. Life is the great adventure. Don't let the invitation pass you by. Time to rise and shine. It's good to be alive, wide awake inside. I'm looking at the world and now I'm not afraid to let my. This is the day that the Lord
no fear, no doubt. Look up, hold on, let go, freedom, yeah. It's good to be alive, wide awake inside.
Okay, ladies, that is it. And I remember, it's good to be alive. Take that day, one day a week for yourselves. And I look forward to seeing you or meeting you back here on the air with your coffee or your favorite tea next Monday with me, Dr. Beverly Swanson-Powell. I love you more. And don't forget to email me with anything that you'd like to discuss with me at info@drbeverlylswanson.com. Until next week, we'll see you then.